I'm here to present my review paper on sustainable use of antibiotics in aquaculture. Introduction. Antibiotics are drugs of natural or synthetic origin that have the capacity to kill or inhibit the growth of microorganisms. Antibiotics that are sufficiently non-toxic to the host are used as chemotherapeutic agents in the treatment of infectious diseases of humans, animals, and plants. Aquaculture is the fastest growing animal producing sector in the world and is expected to play an important role in global food supply. As long as aquaculture practices have intensified in the quality of water supplies in aquaculture cluster areas has deteriorated, the Asian aquaculture industry has been overwhelmed with a wide range of parasitic and bacterial diseases affecting the cultured species. In order to prevent or treat such disease outbreaks, farmers often rely on different types of veterinary medicinal products such as antibiotics and parasiticides, which are mainly applied during periods of high stress in the cultured species. Aquaculture plays an important role in global food production due to changes in human dietary habits. Fish consumption has been increasing, with more people changing to a healthier diet with an appropriate nutritional profile. Okay. Aquaculture is one of the fastest developing growth sectors in the world, and Asia presently contributes about 90% to the global production. However, disease outbreaks are constrained to aquaculture production, thereby affects both economic development of the country and socio-economic status of the local people in many countries of Asia-Pacific region. Aquaculture has become an important source of fish available for human consumption. Antibiotics are very useful additions to any fish health manager's toolbox, but they are only tools and not magic bullets. Survival of fishes works good for men and animals and also for bacteria. Materials and methods. Peer-reviewed journal articles were searched in Google Scholar and then matched in the SCI, Scientific Index Journal, SCI2, and they are analyzed. And journals found in analytics were selected and studied thoroughly. Sustainable use of antibiotics in aquaculture is a review article where the information was collected and compiled from related other journals. Results, review of findings. All the interviewed tilapia farmers reported to apply antibiotics. 10 different antibiotics ingredients were identified, belonging into 5 different classes, which are B-lactam, quinolone, sulfonamides, tetracyclines, and diaminopyrimidine. Overall, the most commonly used antibiotics were enrofloxacin. 59% of the interview farmers declared to use it, followed by the opposite, tetracyclines, 48%, amoxicillin, 38%, and sulfadiazine, potentiated with trimethoprim, 28%. The most commonly used antibiotics were norfloxacin, oxytetracycline, enrofloxacin, and different sulfonamides in shrimp aquaculture. In all cases, antibiotics were reported to be applied mixed with feed once or twice a day for a period ranging between 3 to 10 days or longer until tilapia mortality is decreased. Dosage reported in product labels range between 10 and 100 mg per kg by body weight per day, depending on the active ingredient. Farmers reported to use antibiotics to treat disease outbreaks between 1 to 3 times per production cycle, usually 4 months. In addition, about 70% of the interviewed farmers reported to apply antibiotics routinely to prevent diseases associated with the stress generated during the shedding of changes in river quality, changes in river water quality were reported to be associated to fish diseases, particularly dissolved oxygen drops during the dry season and heavy water runoff events occurring during the beginning of the rainy season are the major reasons. Farmers also reported that high loads of organic material and traces of pesticides from the surrounding agricultural fields, mainly rice crops, could be the cause of mortality observed after runoff events. Runoff events possible to materials or traces of the pesticides could be the cause. Besides antibiotics, farmers also reported the use of pesticides, example, trichloroethylene, tragic quinton, salts na sodium chloride, potassium permanganate, probiotic enzymes and yeast, and other field additives such as vitamin C, proteins and polysaccharides. Discussion. The use of antibiotics in aquaculture may cause development of antibiotic resistance among pathogens infecting cultured animals and humans. However, this is a recent issue and has not yet been thoroughly investigated. Furthermore, there is limited knowledge about the environmental effects of antibiotic use in aquaculture. It is well known that antibiotics are commonly used in shrimp farming to prevent the treat disease outbreaks, but there is little published documentation on details of usage patterns. The possible hazards from the use of antibiotics, including the possible cause of development of resistance, are intertwined and complex. The substances can potentially have adverse effects on the shrimp farming system. Example, through development of resistance among shrimp pathogens or on adjacent ecosystems, example, through toxic effects on aquatic organisms and on human health. Example, through contact with dermatitis or development of resistant human pathogens. To make a risk assessment, the level of occurrence of the substance in question in the environment should be calculated and compared with concentrations of the substance for which biological effects are predicted to occur. Conclusion. The repeated antibiotic use is expected to result in the development of antibiotic resistant bacteria, making antibiotics actually ineffective against the target pathogens. In this way, farmers are forced to increase doses and continuously change antibiotic ingredients, from compromising the environmental sustainability of this aquaculture practice. Further attention must be paid by local farmers and high authorities to control the use of antibiotics in tilapia cage farm production, and to monitor the development and potential consequences of multi-drug resistance for humans and environmental health. Prophylactic use of antibiotics found out to be very common in shrimp aquaculture. Antibiotics are usually used in catfish farming as therapeutic and prophylactic agents. Despite extensive data on the incidence of antibiotic resistant genes in bacteria isolated from catfish in the aquatic environments, the fraction of the overall resistance burden attributed to catfish aquaculture remains unclear. The emergence of antibiotic resistance due to the improvement use of approved antibiotics and users of illegal antibiotics should serve as a wake-up call for regulatory bodies worldwide to move into this matter seriously. Expenses.